Hi, and welcome back. Now that you have a good understanding of MySQL and Azure Database for MySQL, before we dig deeper into its features, let's get our hands dirty and try out Flexible Server ourselves. This is going to be a demo-heavy video, and we're going to cover how to get started with an Azure free account, how to create a server using portal, CLI, ARM templates, and other tools, and also how to connect to this flexible server using tools like MySQL EXE, that's the command line, or MySQL Workbench. First, let's get started by creating an Azure database for MySQL using the Azure portal. We'll also look at the portal experience that is there for the MySQL flexible server. Go to the Azure portal, portal.azure.com, sign into it. And if you don't have an Azure subscription, the best way to get started is to create your Azure free account. In the free account, you actually get MySQL free for up to 12 months and a lot of other features as well. To see what services are free for you, you just have to search free services in the Azure portal and you can get the whole list of services. You can see Azure Database for MySQL written here, up to 750 hours per month of burstable B1MS compute instance, and around 32 GB of storage every month. These are the other services that are available for you. And to get started for creating an Azure Database for MySQL, all you need to do is search for Azure Database for MySQL servers, click on Create, and it will land to this page where you get to choose the deployment option. The first option is Flexible Server, which is usually the most recommended one for production workloads. And then we also have Single Server, which is best for existing applications that are already using Single Server. So let's create a Flexible Server for now. You need to fill in subscription details first. You can either create a new resource group or use a resource group that is already existing, like I have created one for myself. Then you need to give your server name, and this needs to be a unique server name across Azure. So there are also a couple of other rules that need to be followed, and make sure that the name is available before you go ahead. Once it is ready, you can choose your region, the region that is closest to you, and choose the workload type. If you are testing or developing small projects, then the development one, or if it's a large production one or small and medium production workload, you get to choose the workload type accordingly, and your compute and storage will change for each workload. You can also configure the compute and storage to change from burstable to general purpose to memory optimized. All these will be discussed in the upcoming episodes. For now, we will choose B1MS because that's also available for free for you. And then choose a storage size. You can keep it up to 20 GB or 32 GB for now. And there are a lot of other options to choose from as well, but we'll cover more about these in the upcoming episodes. For now, just click on Save and choose the availability zone, MySQL version. Let the high availability and other options be default for now. And just put in your username that you will use to access the MySQL flexible server going forward. Now, the password is also something that you must remember. If you forget it, you will have to reset it altogether. So put in your password, confirm the password, and move on to the next tab, that is networking. In networking, you have to choose a connectivity method, public or private. In this, we will choose public access where there are a few allowed IP addresses through which you can connect to the service. Add your current IP address if you want to connect from your system to the server, and add some tags for the server, and then go on to create by reviewing the server once. So the estimated server creation time is around 5 minutes. Just give a look through of all the server features that you have selected and click on Create. You can see in the notification section now that the deployment has been initiated, and you will be notified as soon as the deployment is completed. Let's go to the resource for now. So this is the overview pane for the MySQL flexible server. You have a lot of details and tabs around. The first and foremost, the server name, the server admin login name, configuration, location, resource group, and so on. And below, you also have a list of resources that can help you get started. You can refer to any of these documentations to start configure networking, connecting to it, configure your database to schedule maintenance, to tune the server parameters for performance, backup restore, and advanced features like high availability and replication. On the top, you can also see a couple of options to stop the server, restart the server, or even reset your password in case you have forgotten it. Now let's go on to look at the other panes like compute and storage. You can verify your compute storage, change it, look at the networking, and make sure that the firewall rules are up to date. You can change it anytime. You can look at the different databases that are there. These are the system databases. Look at connection strings that you'll use for each of the applications to connect to the MySQL flexible server. Server parameters that you will tune, replication functionality, maintenance, backup restore, and so on. You also have monitoring and help and troubleshooting section of the pane. But there's also one interesting feature that is the diagnose and solve problems feature within the server, where you can actually look at if there is any health-related issues found or if any resources that you need to use to troubleshoot the server. For example, if you have a issue with creating a server, then all you need to do is choose the right option. For example, server here, and you get a list of all the top issues that are probably seen and recommendations to make sure that your server creation gets successful. So this ends the overview of all the different options that are there in the Azure portal for you. Next, let's go on to connect to MySQL Flexible Server using the MySQL Workbench. First, let's get some connection information from the database. Let's pick up the server name, the admin login name, and also the password in case you've forgotten it, reset it and get the newest password ready for you. And then go to the networking tab, make sure that public access is selected and the IP address that is of your service is added here. In case you want to connect from any of the Azure services themselves, then just click on allow public access from any Azure service within Azure. You can also add all the IP addresses, but I wouldn't recommend it because it's not as secure. Also download the SSL certificate to make sure that you have a verified connection from your application. Next, let's add a connection in the MySQL Workbench. You need to specify a connection name, then the host name that you just picked up from the Azure portal, also the username that you have specified earlier. The port remains 3306. Just click on OK and let the connection get started. You will now be prompted for entering the password. And once you enter the password, if in case you meet with a connection error, it's usually because your username and password is not right or because your networking access control is not set correctly. So make sure that that is in place before you click on the connection. Now, let us look at the databases that are there in the MySQL server. You can also look at the databases from the Azure portal experience under the database tab. And you can also use this to add and delete the custom databases. Let's add and create a new one. Let's name it DemoDB with a UTF-8 character set and click on save. You can, of course, not delete the system databases, but you can delete DemoDB. Let's keep it as is for now. Let's go back to MySQL Workbench and show databases again. And you will see that the DemoDB is updated here. Use that database. And let's also create and insert some values just to see the working of the database. Let's do a select star to view the values in the table. Next, let's connect to MySQL Flexible Server using MySQL command line. You have to download and install the command line. I already have it ready in my Windows system. Use the MySQL command, specify the host name, username, password, and the SSL certificate that you downloaded earlier, and click on enter. Then you will have to enter the password, and you'll be ready to connect directly. You can do the same actions, show databases, use the demo DB, as well as select star from up table, and there you have it. You can also create a MySQL flexible server using tools like CLI, PowerShell, ARM templates, Bicep, Terraform, etc. In this demo video, we will just look at creating a flexible server using CLI and also look at a sample ARM template for server creation. You can either run CLI directly from Azure portal in the Azure Cloud Shell. This is typically easier. You don't have to log in, and it gives a great experience as well. Or you can install CLI onto your Windows, Mac OS, or Linux system. Let's create a resource group by providing its name and the location in which it needs to be provisioned. The command to create it is just azgroup create, and it typically gets provisioned within seconds. Next, let's create the MySQL flexible server itself. For this, the command is az MySQL flexible server create, and it takes a couple of parameters to create it. Here we'll create a simple one, a burstable B1MS 20 GB storage database. You need to provide the host name, resource group name, location, username, password, as well as the public access IP address. This is actually my current IP, and you can actually indeed add on to it later on. Let's wait for it to finish provisioning. Just as we saw in the Azure portal, it takes a couple of minutes, and here we have it. Now you can either use Azure CLI itself or the Azure portal to manage the server going forward. There are a lot of commands and sample code that is there in our documentation for you to refer to. Next, let's look at a sample ARM template to create a MySQL flexible server. First, you need to provide a couple of parameters and then describe the resource that is flexible server. Its properties, its names, queue, and all the other features that you have seen already in the Azure portal. You can also create a firewall rules within the ARM template and databases as well. Here are the resources that you can use. There are a lot of quick starts, tutorials, as well as samples in our documentation as well as our blog. If you have any questions, write to us at this email ID. Thank you, and I hope you enjoyed this episode. See you in the next.